Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir, and I wish to acknowledge the honourable member for this question. Let me begin by saying, Mr. Speaker, sir, that the health and safety and well-being of all Fijians, including those in the rural areas, is of paramount importance to government. And of course, we will ensure that we do our best within the resources that we have to ensure that that is being achieved. Mr. Speaker, sir, I also wish to clarify, and I think there was a question raised by the Honourable Nawaikula last week on what NDMO is doing and why NDMO is not involved in some of the activities, particularly ration distribution. It doesn't mean that we are not involved. No, we are involved, Mr. Speaker, sir. But I need to clarify the fact that or the ministry and its stakeholders have well complemented this Ministry of Health-led response together with our stakeholders to the global COVID-19 pandemic through the existing machineries of government. So it's a whole-of-government approach, but Ministry of Health-led. And the principal guiding act, Mr. Speaker, sir, is the Public Health Act and not the NDMO Act. That is the big difference in if people are asking what NDMO is doing. Now, there are certain tasks which I will elaborate while answering the question this morning that are delegated to the NDMO. But people probably are so used to our disaster emergency framework, and that is why they are asking the role of NDMO. So I wish to acknowledge again the Honourable Member for this question, because the principal act, as I've stated, is the Public Health Act and not the Disaster Management Act of 1998, which is currently under review, Mr. Speaker, sir. To ensure that all rural Fijians and the Maritime Islands are protected, there are a few measures taken and strategies, Mr. Speaker, sir, again, implemented on the ground as per the guidance and the directive of the Ministry of Health through the Permanent Secretary. One of the key responsibilities given to the Ministry is on the public health campaign, which is on risk awareness. I am grateful to the Permanent Secretary for Health for his trust in the Ministry, and particularly the four divisional commissioners and the provincial administrators and the DOs to lead this campaign, the public health campaign, and particularly focus on the risk awareness and the COVID protocols. And I wish to acknowledge all the key stakeholders, particularly the machinery in the rural areas, the provincial officers, Mr. Speaker, sir, the Rogatuis, Turangani Koros, Maternity Gainers, and the advisory councillors. They are very much heavily involved in the public health campaign. And if you go around rural Fiji, Mr. Speaker, sir, they have come up with their own arrangements within the communities, villages, settlements, which is really helping us and the Ministry of Health, particularly in the control of the likely spread of the virus into the rural areas. So that's one of the key responsibilities given to the Ministry, Mr. Speaker, sir, and that's still ongoing. And the messaging continues to evolve as the trend progresses in Fiji, because one of the key aspects of the whole plan is proportionate response. And that is why the messaging as well goes together with the level of risks and the relevant responses that are happening in the various ministries. To Mr. Speaker, sir, is the enforcement, or maybe I can say the oversight over the COVID-safe protocols. Again, this is where we depend on the community leaders, the religious leaders, individuals, members of household to take responsibility, because this is a whole of nation approach that we are taking, Mr. Speaker, sir. After the public health campaign and risk awareness, what is important is the enforcement and the employment of these COVID-safe protocols, Mr. Speaker, sir. And one of the key measures that was taken by government at the very initial stages of the COVID-19, particularly in Vitilevu, is to restrict the movement of people into the Maritime Islands. And for that, we understand that they still need to be supported, so cargoes still continue as usual. And there is a committee led by the Minister of Industry, Trade and Tourism and Commerce. Again, that's a delegated task from the Ministry of Health, and the Minister and his Permanent Secretary and the Director of Transport are responsible for the coordination and the approval of movement, particularly into the outer islands. And as we speak, Mr. Speaker, sir, as you would know, there is an initiative in place for the safe return of some that were in the Maritime Islands. And of course, there is also consideration, but subject to the strict protocols, where maybe people that are also here in the containment areas can also be allowed to go back, but of course subject to all the protocols that that are in place, Mr. Speaker. So, so that's the movement that is very well managed by the ministry, and of course the key stakeholders are again Itoki Affairs, Maritime Safety Authority, Fiji, and the Ministry of Transport, and so forth, Mr. Speaker, sir. The whole of government support to the health sector, Mr. Speaker, sir, as I've stated, it's a whole of government, it's a whole of nation approach, and there are civil servants who cannot travel to work because of containment protocols, Mr. Speaker, sir, and the lists, together with the Ministry of Public Service, are distributed in the respective divisional commissioners' offices, and they coordinate the work. And of course, we let health concentrate on their technical and very specific roles, whereas all government agencies under the commissioners and together with the permanent secretaries are coordinating these efforts in the rural areas. And this is also includes, apart from manpower, the allocation of resources as well. Mr. Speaker, sir, there are some friends and donors who are so used to the nine cluster systems that we have at NDMO, and they continue to liaise with us throughout this pandemic. And of course, as I've stated, we don't take all the responsibilities on ourselves, but there are some elements that we still take advantage of, particularly because of the nine cluster systems that we have. And there were questions this morning about diapers and baby infant formulas, Mr. Speaker, sir. I'm glad to say, Honorable Speaker, sir, that through these cluster systems, donors came. And we have passed this. There was a handover to the Ministry of Women and Social Welfare and Children and Poverty Alleviation last week, Mr. Speaker, sir, on diapers and baby formulas that were donated through the rural development NDMO machinery, but that has been passed to the relevant agencies as well, Mr. Speaker, sir. Logistics as well, a lot of these activities involve a lot of logistics. I will not go into the details, but that's being coordinated by the ministry as well. And of course, everybody is looking forward to the vaccination program, and that also includes people in the Maritime Islands and rural Fiji as well, Mr. Speaker, sir. But based on the priorities of government, the divisional commissioners and the government machinery in the rural areas are also there to coordinate this vaccination rollout when it does come to the rural and maritime communities. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir.